Well, I've been living here throughout the Somerset floods, and I was profoundly affected by the changes in the landscape and the changes to people's lifestyles and how it affected an entire community. Because I am an artist, I wanted to express my experiences through my work. And also doing things through the arts, you can reach all kinds of people. It's another lens on what people's experiences are.
Very beautiful part of the world. I actually found it very upsetting to see what had happened to the area during the floods, and thought it was a really nice uplifting project to be involved in.
The floods were very devastating. I know people that were involved with the floods and had trouble with it, and it affected them a lot, and this piece is nice to try and bring the community back together in a way to look positively on the floods that happened.
It's a site-specific company. I really like to work outside, even though there can be challenges at the elements, the weather and different spaces.
Dance is a very physical art form, and so it seems especially appropriate to use dance.
I think what I really like about it is that it's involving nature, it's outside, it's challenging, you know, it's a really worthwhile piece. I think it's something that's really exploring ideas and themes that have never really been done before.
I like the theme as well, to commemorate and kind of celebrate how our community came through a catastrophe such as the floods last year.
I think due to the circumstances of what the piece is about, I think it's just being really delicate about the way that it's portrayed, and just trying to make sure that we're taking into consideration people who are still suffering and who suffered during the floods. So just trying to empathise with that situation, having not been through something similar myself.
As an artist, I work with many different art forms, and as this is a piece for the Langport Community Festival and it is about what a community went through, I wanted to include the community as much as possible.
Well, when Sharon first had the idea, I was very, very excited, because I was actually in the flood, so I was one of those people suffering and going through it. And it's really important to be able to remember what that was really like. And for me as a dancer, to be able to work through it physically after the event, almost like a kind of release of a trauma, if you like. And just having all of the memories of the flood and the different aspects of, you know, even not being able to walk properly because you're wading through water. And somehow I think it's really important to show that and for people to remember.
The Langport Community Choir, obviously an art form to do with sound and singing, that was one of the activities that people managed to sustain despite the incredibly difficult access issues for the flood. And some people actually came in their waders by boat to get to choir practice.
I wanted to wear the waders because they were such an everyday occurrence, and I wanted to be almost the spirit of the flood, if you like, or the human spirit in the flood. And so that while there was a narrative and a story going on with the other dancers, I would just be this slow kind of moving figure that was just the memory of the water and the difficulty.
I managed to commission a piece that the choir leader wrote especially for the choir about the Somerset floods, and the dancers are going to be dancing to that during the performance.
There's two songs. One of them is based on a song called The Blackbirds and Thrushes. And it was really when I read that the first rescue from the floods was a rescue of livestock. And so then the words, the blackbirds and thrushes sing on the green bushes, which is quite a mysterious phrase, and it stuck in my mind, along with a stunningly beautiful tune. It's a bigger thing, yes, the people, but the environment, you know, all of nature, as it were, like affected by this thing. It's all affected by it together.
Very interesting, because you're sort of interpreting what we're actually singing. So when you see somebody dancing, it's really, and it sort of makes you think about what you're actually singing.
So the second song is called Fly to Mary, and I heard that the church in Muchelmy has got this amazing painted ceiling. So I went to Muchelmy, and as I drove into Muchelmy, I saw a woman with long white hair, very striking long white hair. And then I walked to the church, and she was also walking to the church. And while I was having a look, she said to me, "You know why this is still here? Because at the time of Cromwell and his men were rampaging around the area, smashing statues, painting out paintings and all that sort of stuff. But they couldn't get to Muchelmy because of the floods." So that was a kind of like coming together moment for me, like, wow, that's an amazing thing to hear. So this that I'm looking at has been preserved because of floods. So I've got the words, "Fly to Mary and come hither." That's from that ceiling painting, as is "Peace on Earth," which also comes into that song.
Fly to Mary, come hither, fly to Mary, come up hither, fly to Mary.
I would like the experiences of a community to be portrayed through the lens of the arts. And I would like to feel that their experiences have not been forgotten and that they have survived them. One of the angles I've taken on the piece is the celebration of community and survival.
What I've really liked is coming together to be let in on Sharon's kind of ideas and images and memories as well from the floods, and then to take a group of dancers. Some were affected by the floods, some came from other parts that weren't affected by the floods, but how we come together and work in a team to make something for a community to enjoy.
We're so used to being confined by the theatre and spaces like that, so it's nice to be outside. Also, the people that I've worked with, the other dancers, you know, they're fabulous. They've been really, really lovely group of people, nice to work with. And everybody who's been involved in the project, from Sharon to Louise to Jilly to everybody, you know, it's been a great community feel, and that's what's been really special about this project.
I've really enjoyed working with lots of different dancers from different areas, and some dancers who have been affected by the flood and some who haven't been affected by the flood, so that's been quite interesting to hear how it affected the dancers, but also musicians and Sharon as well, being the director of the piece, just really interesting to work with the different elements together, and the choir I think is a really unique element to this piece and something I've not worked with before, so I'm really excited about that.
I would like the audience to have experienced art in a new way. This is a very original piece, very rare to have dancers performing with live singing from a community choir. I would like the community to feel that they have been represented in a positive light. I'd like people to have experienced and enjoyed dance, most of whom would never have seen a piece like this.
Well, it's everybody coming together. It's, you know, musicians, dancers, singers, all coming together. That's not very usual thing to happen, event to happen. And I think Sharon's done amazing pulling all that together, and just the energy everybody, and the willingness, which is the same willingness everybody had in the floods, everybody helping everybody, and that's wonderful.
Yeah. Thank you. Castles fall down, tumbling to the sea. Here in my detail that was outstanding because of the preparation of work that must have gone into it. It doesn't appear often where these things appear to be sort of off the cuff. The background to it must have been very impressive to get the moves and the choreography worked out over such a short period of time. To perform like that at the end of it was outstanding, I thought.
Well, it was just so interesting to have something completely different, you know. We're used to this modern music all the time, but this really took you back a few years for one thing. And very, very impressive.
I really enjoyed the whole dance because, like, I dance anyway, so it was really nice to see kind of a mix of different people and then live music kind of combined. It was really good.
I really loved it. I wasn't quite sure what to expect when I got down here, but I could see, tried to portray the grief, the aggravation that people went through, the frustrations with the government response and the Environment Agency response. And so, yeah, no, I that was brilliant. I loved it.
Thank you.